my screen.
Yep. Yeah, but we see what we see is actually the program.
Oh, don't you?
Yeah.
Perfect. And I'll put it in full screen. You see me in full screen?
Yeah.
Perfect. So, good afternoon. My name is Joan Serra, and I'm going to present you part of my PhD that is based on elucidating the mechanism governing the interaction of naturally occurring radionuclides in soils that is within work package 2 of RADONR project. So the objectives of this work are firstly to obtain data sets of sorption parameters for norm of interest in soils that are not contaminated. With this data and also the one that will be recollected from the literature, we will create a KD database to further predict KDs, taking into account the different properties of the soil. And finally, soils from norm sites will be used in leaching tests in order to assess the norm behavior in these scenarios. So first of all, we will perform batch sorption experiments using target norms such as radium in principle. So this method consists in equilibrating the soil with a solution of known concentration or activity of norm in order to analyze the norm that remains in solution after the sorption occur. So we can finally calculate the solid liquid distribution ratio, the KD, which gives us information about the affinity of the pollutant for the soil, as Sarah explained before. And besides, as I just said, with soils coming from norm sites, we will perform leaching tests to obtain information about the norm remobilization in different soils, as well as calculating these option KD values. These experiments, as we can see in these photos, will be carried through a continuous flow sorption technique with a solution that will be dispensed through a column packed with soil, and effluent fractions will be recollected at the end of the column at the specified time intervals. So with this data obtained, and also with the one that will be recollected from the literature, we will create a KD database. So and also we will assess the main properties affecting the sorption of norm in soils. And for instance, as we can see here, the cation exchange capacity and the specific surface area of soils could affect the sorption of norm. And if talking about the liquid phase, we should be also concerned about the pH of the media and also the inorganic and organic carbon dissolved in the liquid phase. Therefore, with all this information, we will be able to construct parametric and probabilistic models to further predict KD values in relevant scenarios. So on the one hand, we have the parametric models that include linear and nonlinear multivariate analysis that will help us to predict KD values that are independent of well-characterized key environmental parameters of soils. And on the other hand, we have the probabilistic equations, the cumulative distribution functions that will be used to examine the KD variability regarding a target norm studied. So in order to reduce the variability of this KD, different datasets will be created according to the properties of the soils. So for instance, we might create a CDF with a partial data set that contains soils that are grouped according to their pH. So in the end, we can obtain something like this, a distribution like this, and we can examine the variability of the specific data set and also obtain the best estimate KD value from the 50th percentile of this distribution. And this was my presentation, and I hope you have any questions so I can answer.
Thank you very much.